Welcome everyone to another Star Wars The Old Republic video, and in this video we're going to be going through some of the upcoming cartel market items that we will most likely see with the new Onslaught expansion, although we might see some of these hit the cartel market a little bit earlier than that. And I'm here on the PTS server. We're going to be looking through the new collections tab and seeing what was recently added to the public test server. And the first one here, we'll jump right into it, is the dual ray mount. Now this one is a platinum rarity mount, meaning it's going to come with a hefty price tag both on the cartel market and on the GTN, and I don't really think it's that aesthetically nice of a mount, to be honest. With a platinum rarity mount, we're assuming that they put a lot of effort into the design and making it something that's really special and unique in the game, and this mount doesn't really scream that. It looks very basic and boxy. There's nothing too special about its design aside from some purple markings on it. What definitely makes the mount stick out is its mount flourish, which has the wings just extend out, and it's cool, but definitely already exists in the game with similar mounts that have probably cooler mount flourishes than this one. So platinum rarity mount, kind of a boxy, not so nice design, but you can make your own opinions about whether this is something that sticks out to you. It might have a special place in the expansion, maybe a cool character rides in it or something, I'm not sure, but in any case, definitely not something that is that exciting for me. But this next one that I'm going to preview here is really cool. This one is a new gold armor set, so not even platinum, and it's the restored Malgus armor set. So that's right, we're getting the armor set from Darth Malgus when he comes back in the recent storylines, and let me say, this is a really sweet looking armor set. It comes with two variations actually. It has the rebreather and it has the full face mask, and you actually get both of them with the entire armor set, so you can kind of see what you like best. The full face mask has more of the ominous Sith type of presence to it. It looks really great with the hood on top, but the rebreather is obviously more classically Darth Malgus. But I've got to say, the whole armor set probably looks better than the original Darth Malgus armor set that we already have in the game. And what I specifically love about this new one is not only its kind of really black color, but the fact that it's plated everywhere. So the pants, the gloves, the sleeves, and the chest plate, everything has this black plating to it, and it really just ties the whole armor set together. So I've got to say, probably one of the better designed armor sets that I've seen recently. Really great. And I could see individually using just the pants or the gloves or the boots for like to mix and match with other armor sets to really make them shine. So I think this is a great armor set in general. Really happy with this one. This next one that we have here is the Legion Blaster Rifle. So this one is a really nice, compact, black colored rifle with a little bit of a green kind of effect happening in the middle. I really like this blaster rifle actually because it's just compact, and I don't think we have a lot of just simple looking blaster rifles. We get a lot of things that are very flashy and fancy. Some are way too big, some have all these things sticking out of them, but this one is just really nice and simple, and I think its simplicity is what makes it so great because it still has like a nice finesse to it, so it still seems like there's some effort put into there. So I could see a lot of people probably liking this one. This one definitely is one that I would consider using. We'll look at the two new lightsabers that we're getting. The first one is the single bladed lightsaber, and this one is actually Arn's lightsaber. So for those of you who don't know, Arn is a new character coming with the expansion, and he is Tau Adair's apprentice, and so this is the lightsaber that he's going to be rocking. It's a really sweet looking lightsaber. It is platinum rarity, and the saber is unstable. So basically, it seems like Bioware, all of the new platinum items that they, or platinum lightsabers that they released recently, all seem to have the unstable effect. That's probably because they know the unstable effect is pretty popular, and they want to make the platinum lightsabers kind of stick out and pop, and the unstable effect really does that. But I think this one is actually really special, and the reason is because rather than being so flashy and like having you know, lightning pop out of everywhere, it's a really nice controlled unstable effect, and I actually think it looks similar to the gray helix lightsaber that we get with the Gree event. It's kind of just more, it enhances the blade without really being an unstable effect. And so it's really cool, and I'll just quickly preview it with the white black color crystal, because with some of the other unstable sabers, like Tula Kord's lightsaber, when we add a white black crystal to it, it actually turns the whole saber black. So I just want to see if it has a similar effect to that. And it seems as though it doesn't really. It's not similar to like Tula Kord's. It has more white than black to it, so I just want to check that out. In any case, let's move on to the double-bladed lightsaber, which for all intents and purposes is very similar. One thing I do want to quickly comment on though is the lightsaber hilt and its design, because it is very Jedi-oriented. It has a really nice aesthetic to it. It's very finessed and very elegant and kind of similar to designs we've seen with like Satele Shan's lightsaber and stuff. So so definitely one that I think is going to appeal to a lot of Jedi characters. With regards to the blaster rifle, sniper rifle, and blaster pistol that we're getting, they're all very similar in design, and you can kind of create your own opinions for it. It's very hard to describe this design. I mean, it definitely is something that's unique and different. It seems to be where kind of all the components and the parts are very exposed and open, and that seems to be its aesthetic. It also has like a stock associated with the back. But if I'm honest, as I was saying earlier, I think it's trying to do too much. I mean, it's cool. I could never see myself using it. I think for a lot of people, it really depends upon how it sounds. And but other than that, like, I really think the other one that I showed earlier, the black one, was a lot nicer than this one. So you can make your own opinions about whether you like its aesthetic or not. Unfortunately, I can't preview the sounds or anything. So for now, we're just going to have to base it off of what we see in the preview window. The new color crystal that we're getting is a teal color crystal, so I'll preview it on just a normal lightsaber here, and we can see that, I'm not honestly sure if we have that color crystal in the game or a similar one. Probably not. I'm hoping that it's something different, but once again, I like to stick with the traditional crystals. I like just blue, green, red, and maybe a white or white-black thrown in. That's basically the extent to which I use color crystals. And finally, we have a new weapon tuning called the Incinerator Weapon Tuning, and I have to say, I'm probably most excited for this one, because the effect is just really neat. All it really does is causes a really big black cloud to show up at the base of your weapon, and it's just a neat effect. I mean, I could see it looking so damn cool in war zones and stuff if you just dual wielding two blaster rifles that just have this huge black cloud associated, like just black cloud shooting out of the barrel. I also preview it on the Executioner's War Staff, which I had highlighted in a really recent video. And basically what this War Staff does is it has a tuning effect located kind of in the middle in the open space. And yeah, just looking at it's cool. I mean, it doesn't make any sense, but it's cool. And I would definitely use this one on like blaster pistols. It would look so cool. It's a little bit underwhelming on the lightsaber. I feel like something like the dark attuned weapon tuning, which is more controlled and red colored, still looks nicer. But definitely on blaster pistols, it looked really cool. And that's it. Those are the items that we have been added so far to the public test server. Hopefully we'll see a few more cool items, but this is already pretty exciting. I mean, just that Darth Malgus set and the weapon tuning are enough for me to be like, hey, we're getting some pretty cool stuff. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know what you guys think about these items in the comment section below, and how excited are you guys for the new expansion? I'm actually pretty hyped. I really have been waiting for something to get me back into SWTOR, and this is definitely, this expansion, the new story, it's definitely got me excited. So hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.